and welcome back to another book review part two. I'm Olivia Lanes. My background is in physics. I did my PhD in experimental quantum measurement, and today I'm going to be reviewing a new selection of books that I think helps me immensely in my journey and my career in quantum mechanics and quantum computing. So the first book that I wanted to share with you is a book from my early undergraduate days. It's called The Six Ideas That Shaped Physics. It's obviously, you know, part of a six-part series. It's called Particles Behave Like Waves. It's made for, you know, an undergraduate curriculum. It's a textbook, but it's really, really readable. And it's really good for people who are just starting out learning quantum mechanics, but may not have a super large foundation in math. And so it starts out explaining the nature of light and the wave-particle duality of photons. It also has another great chapter that I still reference to this day called The Quantum Facts of Life. And it also has a really good set of homework problems at the end of every chapter as well. It's very accessible. Anybody can pick up this book and start reading right away. Even if, like I said, you don't have a lot of math background, it walks you through anything that you would need to know in terms of math. Mine is well-loved and well-worn. You can see all of these sticky notes from literally over the past 10 years of things that I still like how they are explained, and I go back and I reference those to this day. Next is probably one of my most favorite books in the entire space. This is The Strange World of Quantum Mechanics by Daniel Steyer. This was, I think, the first quantum mechanics book I ever read in my entire life. It's, again, not super heavy on the math. It really tries to introduce quantum mechanics with a clarity that comes from understanding not the math side, but more of the big picture ideas. And it gets a little bit into how you can go about understanding these statistics, even if you only come from a classical math background later on. But it starts by explaining the EPR paradox and the Bell experiments and the Stern-Gerlach experiments, which I think are the best ways to introduce quantum mechanics to a non-quantum native audience. It's so interesting. I love the way he explained things. He has some of my favorite quotes in all of quantum mechanic lore. He says that, you know, quantum mechanics takes us to the brink of implausibility, but no further. And I just love the way he explains these experiments. I think he explains it in a way that anybody can understand it. If you're just even a little bit curious about what quantum mechanics are, you should pick up this book. The next book that I would recommend is called Quantum Physics, What Everybody Needs to Know. And I love the title of this book because I really do believe that everybody should know a little bit about quantum mechanics. What I really like about this book is that it starts on the quantum mechanics side of things, and then slowly at the end, it bridges into specific applications of quantum physics, including quantum computing. And the textbook chapter on quantum computing is really, really good, but it also has other applications which are just as interesting, including a chapter on quantum sensing for gravity wave detection. And then it also has some great chapters on the Bell test, the end of local realism, and quantum entanglement and teleportation, things that maybe you hear about in the news, but you don't necessarily deeply understand. And if you're curious about any of these sorts of things, this is a great book for that. And what I also really like about this book is the very last chapter is on future directions and remaining questions in quantum science. And I think that this is such a great way to end this book because I think often the problem with a lot of typical quantum mechanics textbooks is what they really want you to do at the end when, you know, they go to the questions and the homework problems is just shut up and calculate. That's sort of the overarching thesis in a lot of these books is, okay, we don't really understand, you know, what measurement means and what the wave function is, but we don't need to know. You just go ahead and calculate it. And that's fine when you're trying to learn about the math, but I think when you're trying to really understand this on a philosophical level, it's really interesting that he addresses what needs to be progressed in order to have a fully understanding of quantum mechanics and the entire subject. Next is a book that's totally unlike the others that I have already recommended. This is called Totally Random, Why Nobody Understands Quantum Mechanics, and it is a comic book about quantum mechanics and quantum entanglement. If you're obviously already familiar with the math and quantum mechanics, quantum computing, you're not necessarily going to learn anything deep from this book, but I love the way that he explains things and he makes it really fun. And if you're not already familiar with quantum mechanics and you haven't taken a course in it, then I think this is very accessible, it's very readable. I like the illustrations and the pictures in it. I think that, you know, one of the best ways to learn is with good illustrations, and in quantum mechanics that's almost impossible. So I really think that this is it describes itself as a serious comic of entanglement, and I think that's a perfect way of describing it. It has a very light air to it, but the information is solid and it's a fun read. Along that vein, another book I would recommend is The Amazing Stories of Quantum Mechanics. And this book sort of takes the lens of what if quantum mechanics was viewed through the lens of a superhero story. And he describes his book as basically, what if we discussed quantum mechanics and all of the technology that went into the development of it, and told the story of how it basically created all of the technology that we have today. It's a really fun read. He writes it like a, I don't want to say like a novel, but there's no equations in it. But it's not exactly, serious like a textbook either. It's for a general audience, but it's a fun read. And even if you're in the field and you have been for a long time like me, but maybe you're not used to really appreciating how all of the technology that we have surrounding us today is quantum mechanical by nature, this, I think, forces you to step back and appreciate how the development of this technology has affected all of the technology around us today. Next, I would recommend An Introduction to Quantum Computing. This was a new book for me, actually. This is my newest read out of all of these here on the table. I really liked this book because it comes at it from just a quantum computing perspective. It doesn't go into maybe the fundamentals that you would learn in a quantum mechanics course in undergrad or graduate school. It goes straight to the quantum computing part. I always think that that's a really interesting approach to take, and a totally valid approach, because often we talk about how you don't need to be an expert in quantum physics in order to start working in quantum computing. It's, of course, very helpful, I think, to have that background and to have a math and a linear algebra background, especially. But you can learn that in one book, and he does that all here. So he starts by introducing linear algebra and the Dirac notation, and then he goes straight into talking about qubits and quantum computing, quantum algorithms, and then at the end he gets into quantum complexity theory, and some more, I think, advanced topics as well, including error correction. So if you're getting started and maybe you want to go from nothing to getting started in quantum computing programming and algorithm development, this is a great book for that. Lastly, I have Modern Quantum Mechanics by J.J. Sakurai. This is such a good book. I've never met anyone who doesn't like this book, which is like impossible for a textbook that you would read in a graduate level physics course. Everyone usually has one book that they despise, but nobody despises this book. This has a little bit of an interesting history, actually. Sakurai actually passed away before he finished writing this textbook. So with the help of his widow and some other scientists who were working with him, they were actually able to publish this book that he had almost completed after his death. And it actually has a great foreword by John Bell, the John Bell of the Bell's Tests, in it as well, talking about how he started developing this book a long time ago, and he visited Bell when he was at CERN. So it has a really interesting history, but it's also just, it's masterful. It walks you through everything that you would need to know about quantum mechanics. The problems are good. He talks about it in a way that he expects the reader to understand what he's saying. He doesn't condescend, but he doesn't talk down to the reader at all either. Anyway, it's a great book. It's probably for an upper division undergraduate / first year graduate course, but it's something that you, once you own it, are going to reference again and again and again. All right, these are my picks for my next series of best books in the field. I hope you enjoy them. Let me know if you've read any of these or if there are any others that you would recommend. I have a holiday coming up, so if there's any I should read on the plane, let me know.